Hello, everyone, and welcome to Tabor Talk. I'm your host, Michael Tabor. So, you know, Trump is a racist, a monster, an incompetent, and he's a drug addict. So watch this. I'm going to show you a clip, David Pakman. I've done a couple of videos already on this. Is it Sudafed? I don't know. He's on some sort of amphetamines. You know what? I'll say something about this before I play this clip. Maybe somewhat controversial, but I don't think so. Like, hey, if there's one thing, the guy does have energy. He's 73 years old. I mean, who can do that? I couldn't handle that schedule, I don't think. It's just incredible. And yeah, he does come down and he slurs his words when, you know. But the thing is, fuck it, man. I mean, whatever works. Like, there are a lot of journalists on Adderall. So he's a piece of shit. He's on drugs. I don't really give a shit. You know, if it were anybody else, I could, you know, I hate fucking Trump. He's a monster. But yeah, he's on drugs. Watch this.
Okay. So many of you are aware that it is not just cognitive decline that is a possibility to explain Donald Trump's bizarre behavior. But increasingly, the explanation we are seeing get more and more traction is amphetamine use, or better said, abuse. We've seen Trump's upper and downer modes, two very different Trumps, depending on what's going on. And we don't know exactly what's going on. Sometimes high energy, sweaty, red, agitated, speaking quickly, corresponding with the upper phase. And then the slow, slurring, depressed Trump, who often has trouble making sense of the speech that's on his prompter or on paper in front of him, which corresponds with more of a coming down from uppers phase. We've also seen pictures of Donald Trump's Trump Tower desk stuffed with boxes of Sudafed, and specifically a version of Sudafed that's not sold in the United States, and it is more Sudafed than one person can even legally buy at a time in the United States. Now, Sudafed can be crushed up and snorted like Adderall can. It can be taken by mouth. Publicly, Trump often shows signs and symptoms of amphetamine abuse. Some examples include sounding stuffed up whenever he's in downer mode. Has Donald Trump had a cold for the last 3 years? I guess it's possible, but it is common that Sudafed, for example, is a nasal decongestant. It can cause a rebound congestion effect where it wears off, especially when you're taking recreational amounts, as we see that Donald Trump does this often and constantly sounds stuffed up. Trump, in fact, sounded stuffed up during the press conference with Turkish President Erdogan last week, and I'm going to get to that momentarily. Another effect of that rebound congestion after you start coming down from the uppers is that you sniff a lot, which Donald Trump does all the time. As you may have seen compilation videos of Trump speaking and sniffing below between phrases, as I am sort of demonstrating for you right now. Trump also appearing to have trouble speaking when in downer mode. Sometimes it seems as though his dentures are loose, but remember, based on his medical exam, Trump doesn't wear dentures. Rich guys tend not to wear dentures, but to get dental implants. So that's not an explanation. It just so happens, though, that dry mouth is a symptom of amphetamine abuse, be it Adderall or Sudafed. This is what it sounds like when Trump is in that mode.
Let us rethink old assumptions and open our hearts and minds to possible and possibilities. And finally, I ask the leaders of the region, political and religious, Israeli and Palestinian, Jewish and Christian and Muslim, to join us in the noble quest for lasting peace. Thank you. God bless you. God bless Israel. God bless the Palestinians, and God bless the United States. Thank you very much.
There it is. And again, if you don't believe Trump wears dentures, which we've been told he doesn't, and rich people tend not to wear them, dry mouth makes a lot more sense. And it just so happens that it's another symptom of methamphetamine or of amphetamine abuse. So that's all the stuff we knew. The new thing is that I was contacted by an anesthesiologist over the weekend who said, David, I was looking at pictures and video of Donald Trump at last week's press conference with the Turkish President Erdogan. There were bright lights on them. It was a very brightly lit room. And in a normal situation, pupils would be relatively contracted during that situation. But Donald Trump has extremely dilated pupils when you look closely at him from this press conference. Now, of course, in a bright room, pupils should contract if something is not keeping them dilated. As we know, stimulants increase the concentration of norepinephrine in the brain, which keeps the pupils stuck in that open position. An anesthesiologist looked at this and wrote to me, "When I see this, I see someone who is clearly on some kind of stimulant." Now, you also saw Trump blinking a lot and squinting, which would be exactly what you do if you're in a bright room and your pupils aren't contracting. When you go to the eye doctor, as I recently did, and you get the drops to dilate your pupils so that the doctor can look in at the back of the eye, when you get out and go outside, if you're not wearing very dark sunglasses, it is extremely uncomfortable. So do we know for sure? We don't. But it's all shaping up pretty clearly. I want to hear from you. The slurred speech, dry mouth, dilated pupils, upper downer Trump, sniffing and congestion, another known rebound effect of using too much nasal decongestant. Let me know what you think. I want to hear from you. Send me a tweet on Twitter at @DPacman. Leave a reply to the YouTube clip or the Facebook video clip, wherever you are watching. I want to hear from you. What do you think is going on? Today's program is sponsored in part
by... Okay, I'm just pointing the camera, the phone here, instead of at me. Okay, so does anyone have any doubt about it? I mean, he's on drugs, clearly. Okay. Good friends, good books, and a sleepy conscience. Peace, love, and understanding here on Tabor Talk.